Thank you, thank you. Yeah, I have to tell you, I feel a little uncomfortable about being here and speaking, because if you remember, the last time I tried to talk before the commission, I was thrown out by the deputy sheriff, you know, took me out, Paul Strayley didn't want to hear anything I had to say. And so it wasn't a very good experience, so I'm hoping that you three will listen to what I have to say. Jimmy, I know you've always been a really great listener. And Pat, I'm so glad you're here, and Josh. And so what I want to talk about today is, copy from this packet, it's on the page 81, are the texted death threats from the from employee Melanie Hesch regarding Foster County Recorder Lynelle Hoppe. This is something that happened on June 4th. Would you mind? On June 4th, a texted thread of messages came through to Jess Bowe, our emergency manager's cell phone. And in those messages, there were mentions of people, of Lynelle Hoppe being killed. I was hoping that Lynelle would come up and speak to you herself, but I think she's kind of timid about speaking before you and before the public, and I can understand how she feels. After all, can you imagine being on the hit list of 7 or 8 women discussing ways to kill you? And I wrote that down to say it, but when I say it out loud, it sounds terrible. What this does, this reminds me of situations that I got into as a teacher when I had, might have a student who was the target of a bunch of bullies. And in conflict management, what you do is you don't ignore the facts. What you do is you try to put light in the situation. And that's what I've been trying to do ever since that happened. In this case, the target is Ms. Lynelle Hoppe, our elected county official, and she's the target of ex-Foster County employees, people who either resigned or were fired after the voters ousted Paul Strayley and Teresa Rizzini from office. All right, so if this is a group of people, for whatever reason I can't imagine, who have gotten together, texting each other, whether jokingly or not, about different ways to kill Lynelle Hoppe. Now, this was published, this was brought before the commission and published in the Independent, Foster County Independent, and I also published it on my website, carringtonnews.com. And what has happened since that time, I really don't know what has been done about it. I have people calling me and messaging me, asking me, what is the commission doing about this person who is employed still upstairs right now, who said things like, if you look at the in the packet, I gave you copies of the messages that they were sending to each other. She said things like, I should have threw her over the railing, dang it. One of the other ones said, Joel will look out for you now. He doesn't like her either. I mean, we're talking about Joel Lemur, who is a very well-respected person in this county and possibly didn't know anything about this, and yet they're acting as if he would protect this Melanie Hesch from wanting to throw Lynelle over the railing. Another person who was fired eventually said, I could always hit the ditch in the parking lot. And that B word is mentioned several times in these messages. And Melanie Hesch says, please do. And further on, it says, Melanie says, well, maybe I should follow her over the noon hour. Isn't that a characteristic of a stalker? I don't want to mention this person's name, but she worked here too as an employee. I could sniper her. I'll lay on the overpass. Can you imagine what was going on in these women, these people, in their minds when they were saying things like this? Somebody says to Melanie, go stalker, go. She's known as the stalker. Further on, somebody said, well,
She looks like she finally got a backbone about speaking up for herself. And then another person said, well, too bad she doesn't choke on it. And then they laugh at her and they laugh about her and they say really reprehensible things about her. And if any of you, and I'm sure a lot of you do know Lynelle here, she's a wonderful person. She has been doing a good job. She did not get involved with all the, what I consider corrupt practices that were going on in the past. She kind of stuck to herself, did her job. She was not a member of this group. And now this group, it looks like, is out to get her. It's just not right. Something needs to be done about it. Well, what I did when I saw nothing was being done about it, and I can understand with all the stuff that you guys have to go through, you know, taking care of the business of the county, but I saw nothing was being done about it. I wrote a letter to Joel Lemire. I couldn't understand how he could protect somebody like that. And that's what I said. It's in here. What I don't understand is how you can be protective of a secretary, Melanie Hesch, who is involved in texting death threats about our Foster County Recorder, Lynelle Hoppe. Actually, that's how your name came to the Fed's attention. You were mentioned in a texting thread, which included three death threats, along with a text from Cheryl Fettig that said, Joel will look out for you, Mel. He doesn't like her either. So I told Joel about what was going on, and I said to him, Joel, two of my friends who respect you very much have stated that you can't possibly have been aware of Melanie's actions, that you would have taken these texts seriously and would have done something about them. Whether or not you've been aware or involved in this conspiracy in the past, I want to make sure that you and NDSU are now formally informed about what has been taking place during Melanie Hesch's working hours. And then I mentioned I've only copied five of the pages that have the death threats. There were like 10 or 12 pages altogether. Please advise me as to how you and NDSU intend to handle this situation. I would appreciate a response as soon as possible, since many members of our community and I would like to know what steps you're taking to address this issue. The reason I got NDSU involved is because as an educator, universities, education institutions will not put up with this kind of stuff. They don't put up with death threats among their students or among their employees. And so I started writing letters. I didn't get any response from Joel Lemire. He did not reply to my letter. So the next thing I did, I decided, well, I would write to NDSU and make sure that they knew what was going on, because I thought I had been led to believe that Melanie Hesch was an employee of NDSU, as well as of the county. It turned out, though, that, well, the letter that I wrote to the legal counselor for NDSU somehow turned up in the hands of the Attorney General. I got a letter from them saying that, if you look in the back, the last chapter, it's a letter from the Attorney General's office. It says, be advised that the employee referenced in your letter is not an NDSU employee. Now, this is the Ryan Stengel, the office of the Attorney General, who is saying that she is not an NDSU employee. She is an employee of Foster County. As such, there are no NDSU policies relevant to this situation, and any discipline would need to be effectuated by the appropriate personnel in the county. Now, I also got a phone call from the governor's office and a phone call from a couple of other attorneys and a letter back from Chet Pollard, because I wanted him to know what was going on. And they all agreed that this needs to be handled locally and it needs to be handled by the people here. And as far as I'm concerned, it was handled properly. You found out about it, Jessel. Got the messages. She took it immediately to Sheriff Mattice, who investigated the situation. He turned his report over to State's Attorney Paul Murphy, and at that point, I think Paul turned it over to another State's Attorney in Lemoore County, because for some reason you weren't able to handle it. I'm not sure why. Maybe you can explain that to us later.
So, but then it kind of stopped. Nothing else was, as far as I can see, nothing else was done about it. Other than after I wrote these letters and the Attorney General got involved and then suddenly on, I remember the threats took place on June the 4th. On June or July 21st, Joel Lemur wrote a letter of concern to Melanie Hesch. And in it, he says, on June 4th, you sent a group text to present and past employees of the Foster County Courthouse that has been deemed inappropriate by several employees of the county and some in the general public. He goes on to say, that text was sent during working hours. And here's his reprimand to her. In the future, you are not allowed to text or Facebook during working hours unless the text or Facebook posting is work-related. Example, Foster County 4-H Facebook page. You may do personal text or Facebook posts during your morning break and during your one-hour lunch break. So I think this is the only repercussion that came about because of those death threats. And I, for one, am concerned and pretty disgusted about the fact that Melanie Hesch is still working here. After, you know, having such poor, having done such a principal thing. So I want to ask you, is anything else going to be done about this? I think in the letter from, let's see, it's a letter from Chet Pollard. It was interesting because he said, I did have a discussion with legislative counsel in Bismarck about this particular situation, and they said that there are statutes in the Supreme Code in place for the procedure to be followed by local authorities to deal with county matters. Such as this. I do believe your letter pertains to a local issue in the state issue. And what I did at that point, I tried to look up in the Century Code what he was talking about. I found some things. I just attached a copy of a page that I found that's about terrorizing and harassment. I have no idea if it has, you know, really applies to this or not. And I wrote at the bottom, please check with State's Attorney Murphy to see if any of this applies. And so I would like to hear from you, from Paul Murphy, about exactly what this is going on about this. Who's first?
I think if you take this and you put a different name in there besides Foster County Recorder, if this was Governor of North Dakota or if this was President of the United States, I think it would have a lot more gravity, and I don't think that's right. Just the title of the person changes the outcome or the effect of what's been done. But what we can do here, I think, if she's a county employee, we do have control over the budget, and I do think that her direct supervisor should be compelled to put her on notice, give her a one and final warning, because I mean, this, what he said there is basically, don't do it at work. Well, as a county employee, I don't think she should be doing this ever to nobody should be doing it to anybody, whether it's a joke or not. And then, if it was all just a ha-ha joke, how careless is it that you're involving another county cell phone in it? I mean, I think there should be a personal apology from the person in question here to the person that it affected. And like I say, I think they should be put on notice. This is their one final warning.
You know, I've been asked for my legal opinion on this, and Mr. Carr's been in my office, Mr. Copenhaver's been in my office asking me about this, and I gave them my legal opinion is that this can be taken care of within the budgetary process. We have the two people that are the main characters in this whole thing. We've got one who's elected, who the commission doesn't have a handle on except for over that budget. And we have another department who is the hired one, and they do have control in addition to the budgetary process. So that's their options to do with what they want under what they have control over.
in the future, I think we should probably encourage all the employees, if they have a problem, rather than letting it fester, back up and turn into a storm like this, maybe they should come forward and talk to the commission, talk to the auditor, talk to the sheriff's department, talk to somebody, so it comes in here and we actually vet it out, rather than supposedly festering for 18 months and turning into what we got, which is totally unacceptable. It'd be unacceptable if it was at my place of employment, it'd be unacceptable if it was at your office, it'd be unacceptable in the shop too. I mean, it's just unacceptable. And I mean, I don't know that it warrants immediate termination, but I think it definitely needs to be put on notice. This behavior will no longer be accepted from a county employee, ever.